All right, Dale. Next up on your list, Funkadelic, not just Knee Deep.
Yeah.
And man, I mean, to say that George Clinton has influenced you is an understatement. I wish my brother George is here. Is heavy on the Parliament samples. But that was a question I had for you. I know that the title of "I Wish My Brother George Was Here" is a Bugs Bunny reference, mm-hmm. but is it also a George Clinton reference?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is, but like sideways, I think. Like,
yeah.
Cube asked me like, what did I want to, what I want to title the album?
Yeah.
And I think I was just kidding. It was like, I wish my brother George was here. He's being stupid or something, right? And I think he was like, okay, yeah, that's tight.
That
yeah.
kind of makes sense. He yeah, was probably yeah, thinking yeah. more of this, and yeah. they were kind of like.
He knew the reference from Bugs Bunny, but yeah, like, yeah. he flipped it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. okay, I'm going to take you serious. Like, yeah.
Right.
Okay.
So
it worked, yeah.
Yeah, tell us about Knee Deep and Funkadelic.
Again, this is just futuristic to me. Like, like you still play this now.
Oh, yeah. Totally.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. That is just the rawest. Like, this. It just sound real kind of evil, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Like, especially when it switched to this part.
Yeah.
I just like that shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It just sound real, like, nasty.
Yeah. How about some of the records that sampled it? Me, Myself, and I, Dre Day.
They was cool.
Yeah, you know those?
Cool, but yeah. The original still is, tighter to me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I fool with George Clinton.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I still try to holler at him every now and then, too.
George Clinton was, a staple in the Bay Area, though. I mean, those two went together. So you probably, growing up, you were...
I used to be scared of the covers.
Oh, yeah.
Record covers used to scare me because they were so crazy looking.
Yeah. That's funny. Georgia Ann Muldrow said the same thing when we had her on the show.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, when she was growing up, like, she'd look at the album covers, the Parliament ones, and be like, what's going on here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's then I get older, I'm like, okay, he the shit actually.
Yeah.
And so, just the humor that he would use too, like it just inspired me. Like I was like, okay, you could do stuff like that on a song.
Yeah.
Before that I thought that was like illegal or some shit. Like,
right.
Like all the shit that I thought you couldn't do in a song, like for entertainment.
Yeah.
He would just anything.
Can you give us an example on one of your records where you kind of took that idea, like, okay, George did, let me just experiment with this a little bit.
Everything, really.
Okay, yeah,
like,
all right.
Like, even now, like, George, when hip-hop was coming out, he wasn't like, man, fuck this shit, I hate the fool sampling.
Right.
He wasn't even like that. He was like, oh, okay, I remember when they was doing that. Know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
He already peaked that, okay, that's just they doing this over again.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
So he knew how to freak it, you know what I'm saying? Because he come from the blues, you know what I'm saying? The essence of all this shit. So he's seen all the musical styles since then.
Right.
He know how it all relate, you feel me? So that just impressed me, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That he could see that, and he didn't hate on the youngsters.
Yeah,
he understood them. You know what I'm saying?
How far in were you able to actually meet him? And
he was on my first album.
And that's when it.
So you cleared all that stuff and he was credited. So
yeah.
So he was well aware of all the work.
I mean, he's on the record. Like first little intro song, he on it.
He's
on
it.
Yeah. That's him. What is a booty? And how do I know that's him?
I didn't know that.
He's actually on the shit.
Okay, shit.
Brides of Funkenstein on my shit too.
Yeah. I mean, listen, I've played that album, both of your first two albums, probably 100 times each. I never knew that. So that's amazing.
He was on there. I was scared too. Like, I was like, that's George Clinton.
God. How old were you when that happened?
Shit, 18 probably.
Wow. Yeah. Come skateboarding into the studio. Like, who are you? Oh, damn.
Yeah,
I mean, first Cube asked me, like, how would you feel if George Clinton was on your shit? Would you like that? And I was like, wow, you could get George Clinton? He's like, yeah, we can get the Brides of Funkenstein, too. We're going to try.
Yeah.
I'm like, wow, okay, yeah. Like, I was just like, okay, yeah, shit. Like,
Cube's like, as long as Electra got the budget, we getting all these people.
I don't even think it was about that.
Okay,
like, just like... Because he loved the funk, too. Really,
right.
I picked up the funk hella from him.
Yeah. Right.
Because he's my older cousin. So I go, and then his older brother and his older sister, they would really be on George Clinton.
Yeah.
You feel me? So I go over to their house, and that's what it was.
Right. Okay.
Like, you know, kind of like that. That's that gangster boogie too. You feel me?
Yeah. No. 100%.
So like all the OGs out in LA, yeah, they listen to this shit.
Yeah. Yeah. This was the barbecue song right now.
Yeah. You
this
feel
was,
me?
Yeah.
So you. So yeah, you were heavy on the Parliament samples, Funkadelic, you know, on that first album, and but then you took a you went more like jazz based and mm-hmm. and Rear Groove kind of for No Need for Alarm. But did you at that point when you switched for the second album, did you feel like, okay, I did that already, so now I'm going to go this way? Or
The story is kind of complicated with that, or is it? Maybe it was complicated for me,
mm-hmm.
but that was mainly because there was a lot of people around me in school and stuff that was kind of was saying I was selling out.
Right.
Because I was using Parliament Funkadelic, which is hella funny because how could you say that's selling out using
right.
their music?
Right,
like,
right, right.
That's as raw as you can get.
Yeah.
I guess it became more popular after that.
Right.
But I just kind of took it like, you know, I'm not being respected or something. So the second album, I just was like, let me show everybody that I'm a real MC.
Right.
I could really do this, you know what I'm saying? I could chop up samples or whatever, you know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah,
just to prove that I could do it.
Yeah.
But now looking back, I'm like, okay, I didn't even have to do all that. Like, dudes was just jealous of me
of
or whatever,
right,
you know
right.
what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, you know, when I was young, the peer pressure was real.
Right, right.
Sounds kind of like what De La went through with their first album and the
yeah.
second. Kind of like, the, okay, you got, okay, let's do it this way so you guys
yeah.
can
yeah.
But,
really
I mean, that's
see
dope
MC.
Because, you know, it really it shows that you can successfully reinvent yourself. I mean, like Beastie Boys did the same thing. De La
yeah.
the same thing. You know what I mean?
And I respect all them dudes. Like
yeah.
Beastie Boys is
yeah.
one of my favorite groups of all time. They
yeah.
showed me hella love too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Same thing with De La. They mm-hmm. showed me hella love too. But like I respect them as musicians too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Especially the Beastie Boys. I really fool with the Beastie Boys. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. But the funk is jazz is the funk too. Like that's
yeah.
where it started
yeah.
with that. So
yeah.
like. Anything, like anything I can make it funky, you know what
yeah.
I mean? That's how I look at it.
All right.
Oh, sorry.
Funkadelic.
It's all
knee
good.
Deep.